An insidious environmental catastrophe. The desert will win. As has been the case for many decades, environmental catastrophes are also being pre-programmed today, as well as all other terrible things which are connected with it, such as climate change, destruction of the ozone layer, water pollution, hunger catastrophes, energy shortages, rapidly spreading diseases, maladies, epidemics, hatred of foreigners, racial hatred, discrimination against women, maltreatment of children, torture of animals, unpeace, war and felony, and so on and so forth. But what is really to blame for all these terrible things? Indeed, solely the life hostile and steadily growing overpopulation, which needs more and more of everything imaginable. Consequently, more and more things have to be produced, which again entails that the terrible things thereby become bigger and never-ending and are never resolved, because if one terrible thing is tackled, then it is only fought to a certain degree, and indeed, usually only very half-heartedly, because politicians and industrial leaders and so forth can thereby preserve their positions and on the other hand can earn immense amounts of money, with which they line their own pockets, of course. Furthermore, it can be seen that attempts to tackle terrible things are usually nothing more than senseless efforts to combat the symptoms and a token exercise. Because, on one hand, the terrible things are not seized by the root and eliminated. Rather, a symptom is only fought half-heartedly and reluctantly. And, on the other hand, it only happens in order to keep up appearances for the public. There though much more severe terrible things in both the near and distant future are already pre-programmed today, indeed in every regard. The same also holds true for hunger catastrophes, which for many decades and centuries have again and again been rolling over the earth, which, however, in the future will become more devastating due to the incessant increase in overpopulation, which, above all else, is altogether the origin of all terrestrial terrible things and catastrophes on Earth, and which, fundamentally, must be reduced through a worldwide, determined and uncompromising stop in births and an intentional and international global birth control, until the human population of roughly 529 million people is re-established again, a population that is compatible with the planet's size and with nature. Due to the insanity of the terrestrials who reproduce uncontrollably like rabbits, catastrophes of every kind are now pre-programmed for the near and distant future, and therefore also the Earth's desertification. Increasingly more farmland, pastures, and forests throughout every country on Earth are converted into infertile deserts. Already today, 70% of the dry regions in the world have deteriorated into deserts and steppes. This amounts to more than 3.6 thousand million hectares, 8.6 thousand million acres. More than 1.2 thousand million human beings today are already threatened with hunger. One out of every five Earth humans, around 300 million of them, are already affected not only by hunger or as refugees, but also by the desertification of their land areas, precisely by the advance of the desert into semi-arid regions, heretofore still used by human beings. The striking fact thereby is, precisely the emergence of deserts and steppes is one of the largest and most serious environmental catastrophes on Earth today. Especially about that, however, frequently completely wrong ideas prevail. Indeed, not only with lay people, but also with certain scientists. In fact, it is not simply a case of deserts forming due to gigantic sand dunes pushing it forward and forcibly burying fertile land beneath them. And it is also not correct that, for example, the front of the Sahara extends across Africa to the south, so roughly from Senegal to Ethiopia. Of course, deserts have always spread, indeed over periodic intervals, and practically always during times of extreme drought. However, when adequate rain falls, a countermovement automatically occurs. This automatically occurring countermovement is quite a natural phenomenon that has occurred for as long as the deserts have existed. In contrast, however, the desertification is a completely different phenomenon. Though it totally new deserts and steppe landscapes emerge, while however semi-arid regions, and therefore those that are dry for most of the year, but otherwise still productive, completely dry out and fill with sand and so forth. These processes, however, are not restricted to the Gobi Desert, the Sahara, or other vast desert regions. Because desertification, therefore the formation of new deserts, for example, also occurs in Bulgaria and Romania, as well as the south of Spain and Turkey, whereby these are but four of nearly 100 countries where increasingly more arid land is turning into deserts and steppes. The greatest danger in this regard is in Asia. Indeed, as a result of the very high population density, which steadily and unstoppably continues to increase. The desertification process, however, is farthest advanced in Africa. The ensuing damage for all of this desertification is immense and is estimated at about $45,000 million per year, of which around $22,000 million occurs in Asia, and indeed every year. In Africa, it can amount to approximately $10,000 million, $6,000 million in North America, $3,000 million each in Australia and South America, whereby also Europe is facing damage estimated at $1,000 million. Naturally, the formation of deserts and steppes is furthered by droughts, but also through other climatic influences. The principal cause for the formation of steppes and deserts of many areas rests primarily and fundamentally with human beings themselves. For they not only feloniously and recklessly drive their populations into dizzying heights, but they also destroy the land by having to increase food production to feed the incessantly growing human population and therewith completely leaching and depleting the ground of all its nutrients, without the soil being able to recover or be regenerated artificially with the necessary vigor that was also extracted, wherethrough the ground becomes completely exhausted. Therefore, it is not enough to only bring new nutrients into the ground, because the soil also requires natural vigor, which the human being cannot give back. As a result, much more is extracted from the soil in the long run than can ever again be given back to it. This means, however, that the soil dies, and the deserts and steppes come forth from it. Often, or even in most cases, nothing other than purely infamous, irresponsible, and nature-destroying pathological craving for profit lies behind the human culpability of the desertification of large areas, which, for example, is especially evident in Argentina, where vast areas are leased for short-term periods to large-scale farming enterprises, which then, by hook and crook, and with all means that are not allowed by nature and are damaging to it, bring out an absolutely maximum yield, and after only a few years leave behind a totally leached-out desert or steppe. When considering Africa, evidence shows that the enormous overpopulation there does its destructive mischief just as much as everywhere else. However, the general poverty is probably greatest in Africa because this continent and its population is exploited the most by industrialized welfare states of the white races, which in turn leads to large parts of the African population trying to extract as much as possible from their barren soils in order to survive. Subsequently, the soil is destructively overused, which drives it to the total exhaustion of its nutrients and to its death. All of this is a destructive, vicious cycle. The more and the faster the population grows, the poorer it becomes because neither opportunities for earning a living, nor any types of essential goods, and other materials and so forth are available. This in turn leads to human beings pouncing on the fertile soil in order to plant seeds and harvest food from it. However, the more that is extracted from the farmland and pastures to feed the incessantly growing families, the faster the soil dies and turns into desert or steppe. Indeed, the soil becomes increasingly less productive and slowly but surely becomes barren until it is completely ravaged. And because overpopulation continues to grow and hitherto cannot be stopped due to the human being's felonious irrationality, thus far also no prospects exist to get the insanity of overpopulation and the catastrophes resulting from it, or the poverty and starvation of thousands, millions of humans beings under control and to stop. Consequently, also no hope exists for stopping the insidious destruction of the agricultural land and the arable, albeit already scarce, soils. Meanwhile, the human beings continue to potter about in their greed for profit and in their uncontrolled rabbit-like procreative insanity, without thinking about where the fundamental reason for these catastrophes and malicious happenings really is to be found. Environmental conferences are held, such as the one in Rio in 1992, or desert conventions, such as the one in Paris in 1994, or a climate summit, such as the one from March 28th to April 7th, 1995 in Berlin, which devour $40 to $50 million, and indeed, senselessly and for nothing, because nothing whatsoever is achieved that would change the situation. Those in responsible positions only reside well in expensive hotels, eat and drink well as, in order to have an alibi and to satisfy their pretense, they give nonsensical and banal speeches without ever really saying anything substantial, wherethrough a solution can never be achieved. At such senseless conferences and summits and so forth, politicians and business executives and so on simply have pleasurable days and a jolly good time at the expense of the taxpayers, while the population in some home countries starves and the taxpayers in other countries toil long and hard and labor to pay for the participants' enjoyments and culinary delights. Such conferences and summits are merely based on megalomaniacal, tasteless, senseless, and misleading hypocrisies, and on sensical speeches. Without the participants themselves understanding anything of their own hollow prattle, let alone the feeble-minded speeches by the other attendees. Therefore, nothing is ever accomplished that would bring to an end the terrible things on earth and reveal the actual reasons for all the terrible things and catastrophes and so forth, namely that the origin for the entire terrestrial terrible disasters of all calamities and all mischief is solely related to the fact of humankind's excessive overpopulation, from which all and everything results that slowly but surely ultimately destroys and eliminates all life on Earth.